The way you structure sentences can have a purposeful effect on how readers determine the importance of the information you are providing. Sentences can have restrictive or non-restrictive elements. A non-restrictive element is a phrase or clause that adds unnecessary information to the meaning of a sentence. The phrase or clause can be left out of a sentence without changing the sentence's meaning. Non-restrictive elements contain commas, dashes, or parentheses to separate the unnecessary information from the rest of the sentence. A restrictive element is a phrase or clause that adds information that is essential to the meaning of the sentence. The meaning of the sentence changes dramatically when the phrase or clause is removed. Restrictive elements do not contain commas, dashes, parentheses, or any other form of punctuation to separate the information from the rest of the sentence. This sentence contains a restrictive element. Students who spell all words correctly will receive a special surprise. The phrase "who spell all words correctly" is a restrictive element. Notice that there are no commas in the sentence. Removing the clause would change the meaning of the sentence. The sentence would now imply that all students will receive a special surprise instead of only those who spell all words correctly. Therefore, the clause is essential to the sentence. This sentence contains a non-restrictive element. The envelope, which had no stamp, was still sitting on the table in the kitchen. The clause, "which had no stamp," is a non-restrictive element. Notice that the sentence contains commas. The clause can be removed and the reader will still know the location of the envelope in the house. The reader does not need to know that the envelope did not have a stamp because that information is not necessary to the meaning of the sentence. Parenthetical elements are a type of non-restrictive element. A parenthetical element is a side remark or interruption that adds information. Some examples of parenthetical elements include "by the way," "for example," and "however." They, of course, were selected to be the leaders of the group. "Of course" is a parenthetical element that interrupts the sentence and is not necessary. They were selected to be the leaders of the group. To avoid confusion, parenthetical elements are usually set off by some form of punctuation. Parenthetical punctuation includes commas, parentheses, and em dashes. The type of punctuation used depends on the degree of interruption caused by the interrupter. Commas are the lowest degree of interruption. Parentheses are a middle grade of interruption. Finally, em dashes are used for the highest level of interruption. A comma is a punctuation mark that indicates a pause between parts of a sentence. It is also used to separate items in a list. "Although the temperature was below freezing, she waited outside for her ride." "Although the temperature was below freezing" is separated from the rest of the sentence by a comma. The non-restrictive element adds information but is not necessary to the sentence. When the non-restrictive element is removed, the sentence reads, "She waited outside for her ride." Alex, our team captain, is moving at the end of the year. Our team captain is a non-restrictive element that provides added information about Alex. Therefore, it should be set off with commas. Commas are used here because the interruption is mild. The interruption in the sentence can be removed without dramatically changing the meaning of the sentence. Alex is moving at the end of the year. Parentheses are pairs of rounded brackets placed around information that is inserted as an explanation or afterthought. The inserted information is not necessary to the meaning of the sentence. Rosa Parks, born February 4, 1913, was a civil rights activist. The phrase "born February 4, 1913" is separated from the rest of the sentence by parentheses because the information is more of an aside that breaks the flow of the sentence. It is not necessary to the sentence. When the phrase is removed, the sentence reads, "Rosa Parks was a civil rights activist." Sabrina took the dog, the one with the broken leg, to the veterinarian. The phrase "the one with the broken leg" is an interruption. Therefore, it should be enclosed by parentheses. Without the interruption, the sentence reads, "Sabrina took the dog to the veterinarian." Parentheses are used instead of commas because the information is more of an aside than part of the conversation. Em dashes are a type of dash reserved for the highest level of interruption. Em dashes are used to create dramatic pause or special emphasis. they emphasize information that interrupts the flow of the sentence. M-dashes also highlight a special comment or shift in meaning. Additionally, M-dashes can be used in dialogue to show hesitation. Milo's mother asked him if he had cleaned his room.
I forgot to clean it today,
Milo replied. M-dashes are used here to show Milo's hesitation when speaking to his mother. The easiest way to tell the difference between M-dashes and hyphens is to look at the length of the mark. An M-dash is a longer line. Again, M-dashes are used to create dramatic pause or special emphasis in sentences. A hyphen is a shorter line that is used to connect two or more words. For example, good-hearted and well-known both contain two words. As compound adjectives, both pairs of words are connected by hyphens. M-dashes provide additional detail by stopping the flow of the sentence to ensure the reader pays close attention to the information within the non-restrictive element. My best friends, Misty, Olivia, and Bailey, will be at my birthday party. As you can see, M-dashes are used to separate Misty, Olivia, and Bailey from the rest of the sentence. This is done to specify the identities of the speaker's best friends, who will be attending the speaker's birthday party. Using commas and parentheses would add less of an emphasis than dashes. After a month of being sequestered, the jury reached a verdict: guilty. The M-dash is the best parenthetical punctuation to use to create a dramatic pause. Here, the author uses the M-dash to highlight a special comment at the end of the sentence. Adding non-restrictive elements to sentences is an advanced way of bringing variety and structure to your writing. The parenthetical punctuation you choose determines how emphatic or important the information is to the rest of the sentence.